Welcome to this Soton Brain Hub video on the ventricular system of the brain. The ventricular system of the brain is a set of four interconnected cavities that produce and circulate cerebral spinal fluid. Each of these cavities, also known as ventricles, contains a region of choroid plexus that is responsible for producing the cerebral spinal fluid. In this diagram, the choroid plexus can be found in the regions highlighted in red. An overview of the circulation of CSF through the ventricular system of the brain is demonstrated here by the yellow arrows. So firstly, if we start with the lateral ventricles found in both cerebral hemispheres, each lateral ventricle resembles a C-shaped structure that begins at an inferior horn in the temporal lobe and travels through the parietal and frontal lobes, where it ultimately terminates at the interventricular foramen, also known as the foramen of Monroe. Each foramen of Monroe connects a lateral ventricle to the central third ventricle. The third ventricle is a small slit found between the two thalami. We can also see here in the left diagram the interthalamic adhesion connecting the two thalami, and that it runs through the third ventricle. Next, the CSF flows from the third ventricle to the fourth ventricle via the cerebral aqueduct, also known as the aqueduct of Sylvius. The fourth ventricle has a characteristic diamond shape and is found within the pons and the upper part of the medulla. From here, CSF can pass into the central canal of the spinal cord, or via three small foramina, it can flow into cisterns of the subarachnoid space. These three small foramina include a single central foramen of McGendy, which can be found here, and also two lateral foramina of Lushka, which can be found here. Cisterns are any openings in the subarachnoid space created by the separation of the arachnoid and pia mater. For example, in this diagram we can see the cisterna magna, also known as the cerebral medullary cistern, found here. We also have the pontine cistern, found here. We also have the interpeduncular cistern, found here. Just anterior to the interpeduncular cistern, we have the chiasmatic cistern. And finally, we have the quadrigeminal cistern, found here. Once the CSF has left the fourth ventricle via these three small foramina into the subarachnoid space, the CSF can flow around the spinal cord and the brain before being reabsorbed by arachnoid granulations. Arachnoid granulations are small protrusions of the arachnoid membrane through the dura into the venous sinuses, the largest of which are found in the superior sagittal sinus. The cerebral aqueduct and foramina are very small and narrow, which means they can easily become blocked, causing an increased pressure in the ventricles. This condition is known as hydrocephalus, but this will be covered in another video. This is the end of this video on the ventricular system of the brain. Thanks for listening. If you have any feedback or questions on these videos, please
subscribe to Soton Brain Hub for more videos to help explain the mysteries of the brain.